My name is Izzy, and this is my best friend, Tessa. We're professional skiers and mothers, and a few years ago, we were faced with some really hard things. My marriage to my son's dad fell apart, and less than a year later, Tessa's husband, Dave, passed away in a tragic ski accident. Suddenly, being forced to carry the load of parenthood on our own made us realize we are capable of things we never imagined. 3 years later, life looks different. I have an amazing partner, a new baby, and Tessa is crushing life as a single parent to her three wild boys. We've dialed in our systems, found our stride, and are committed to keeping our lives full of adventure. Things don't always go as planned, but for the most part, we got this.
I think at first when Dave passed away and all of a sudden, like, I had to pick up the mother load and, like, take on so much stuff. There's this, like, superhuman strength that takes over and you're like, I got this. Okay, I gotta take on that role too. I can do this.
Casper, get your boots on.
And it doesn't take long to realize that really, yes, the mother load is more than I can carry on my own.
Casper, please carry your backpack.
And I need help with it.
In 2018, Knox was about to turn one, and I was married at the time, and our marriage was definitely struggling, and we decided to go our separate ways, and I was suddenly a single mom. That summer, I connected with Justin, and he kind of just slowly started integrating into our lives and embracing the chaos. And he can tell when things are kind of falling off the rails. He'll be like, you should go for a run or you should go for a walk.
It's really important for her to get that time away, and whether that's exercise or whatever she's doing, she comes back recharged every time, and it just resets the family.
What do you say, Knox?
I think a person is able to give so much more of themselves to everyone else when they've taken that time for themselves first.
It's actually so perfect how Knox's school and daycare are right on the way to the ski hill. Makes it a convenient drop-off. So, thank goodness I have my mom really close by, and she's taking fits for the day. Justin's working. So she has fits for most of the morning, and Knox is at daycare until 4. So we'll get some shredding in.
If you want, you can just take her for a walk in the stroller.
Okay.
She's such a great mom, such a great grandma. She lives a block away from us. She's basically up for anything. The thing about Mimi, though, is she also loves skiing, so we definitely have to fight over the powder days sometimes, you know? She's not one of those grandmas that's just sitting at home, like, knitting.
What a day, my heart is full of butterflies. There's no disguise in how I feel whenever I'm with you. I've waited till the moment's right to look into those starry eyes and say the words that I'm thinking all the time.
Roll over and get in it.
My dad's great. He does as much as he can. Everything he does it to the fullest. And so he skis every day and mountain bikes every day. But he also takes time for us. And if I need his help, he's like willing to take time for us every day.
My heart goes out to Tessa because within 2 years, she lost her mother. That would be my wife. And then her husband. And nobody should have to undergo that kind of junky stuff.
Is that on?
Rabbit hate day.
Hey, Rabbit.
You're either always going to be happy or you're always going to be sad. And that's a choice that you can make.
He said, well, walk this way, ma'am. She said, well, if I could walk that way, I wouldn't need it.
And I know what Tessa is. She's very positive and she's inspirational. in my life. If I can ever give her any kind of a boost.
Is that mommy?
Then I'm in.
The more I like watch my boys and thought, okay, what are we missing? What do we need? It's like, well, if I get a nanny who can come and cook and clean, she probably isn't gonna dirt bike with my kids, or she's probably not gonna teach them how to do 360s when we go skiing. I think we need something different. And so we ended up hiring these two guys to come and live in our suite, and we called them the Mountain Mannies.
The snow looks like it's green.
The snow is, yeah, I guess if your goggle lenses make it look green, that's fair.
My name is Aiden Trudell. I am a mountain manny, as the boys like to call it. When the opportunity arose and Tessa asked if I could come and maybe help out on the property and help take care of the kids and live with them, I was like, sign me up right away. To just see her in such a hard time kind of made that side of my brain really light up, as like, this is probably the greatest opportunity I might have in my life to have such an impact on a family of rad people.
Walk in.
I'm only giving you guys candy if you behave. It's rowdy. Definitely very rowdy.
No skis. They're just so loose that they just bloop.
These skis just fell off?
Yep. Yeah.
I bet you we should tighten it in.
Maybe.
Perfect. Let's go, boys. Nice butter.
When I get to see Tessa go out, even for a 5-kilometer run, it literally makes my heart explode, because I just know that that's all she wants, you know, at one point in the day, to just be able to connect back with her old self. He's a big snorer.
Manny did his job.
Super lucky to have these people in our lives, and they just make it possible to not get too sucked into the labor of the mother load.
It definitely takes a village. It feels like the whole ski hill helps me parent at times. It's awesome. I personally like hate asking for help, and it's a learning process, and I'm always trying to channel my inner Dave, because Dave could ask anybody for anything.